So I am Adam Krellin.
Mein Name ist Annika Melis.
Ani Alon Tenzer.
Λέγομαι Adrianos Golemis.
Ani Eliad Youssef.
Io sono Simone Paternostro.
Ich bin Robert Wild.
Ich bin Thomas Weine.
Und ich bin eine Analogastronautin.
And I'm here as a analog astronaut at the Austrian Space Forum.
I studied space engineering in Italy.
I have a background in microbiology.
My big passion is space medicine and human spaceflight.
As I'm very interested in space, I managed through the years to work in the space sector as a medical doctor. So right now I'm working for the European Space Agency.
I'm a physicist. I do research currently at the University of Innsbruck. I'm a scientist and I just want to find out things that we don't know before.
Ever since I can remember, I wanted to become an astronaut. That's my childhood dream. That's also why I decided to study natural sciences, so mathematics and physics, join the Netherlands Air Force Reserve, get my advanced diving certificate, get a parachute license.
I've always liked to combine both physical, mental challenges with scientific ones. Being an analog astronaut just gives you the opportunity to do both in one place.
I really like connecting things and to see connections and to learn new things, meet new people, work in an interdisciplinary, international environment. So yeah, kind of like a butt on a bucket.
I luckily turned 25 2 days before the application deadline, and which then allowed me to apply.
The selection process was extremely interesting, but also very difficult. They push you to your absolute limits to see what you can do, both physically and mentally. I found, you know, limits that I hadn't pushed before.
And the Austrian Space Forum is an association that is particular in the sense that we simulate spacewalks. And I think that there's a lot to learn from that, scientifically, but also personally.
It sparked my curiosity. What you can do here on Earth to contribute to space exploration, human spaceflight.
Because when, like at the time where Columbus discovered America, nobody knows what was beyond the Atlantic Ocean.
And today we build spaceships and we try to figure out what's out there.
And so it's actually, in this case, is both exploration, because being there is different to send a rover or satellites, because then you have machines working and just collecting data.
You know, everyone remembers the day Neil Armstrong stepped on the moon, but no one with it outside of the field really remembers the first robot on the moon.
When you think about it, that the first person that would walk on Mars is probably already born, this generation is going to determine the future of space exploration.
So yeah, find whatever part of a STEM subject you enjoy, whether that's astrophysics, whether that's medicine like myself, go off and just throw yourself into it and just enjoy being a geek about your subject.
And I'm really thankful to be part of this this effort. I think it's one of the biggest, most important endeavors that humanity can pursue today.
I'm an analog astronaut.
The mission to Mars is going to be the grandest journey of our next generation.
We are exploring tomorrow.